Hello and greetings from Iceland. And what a day that we've gone through and what a night since it was announced that the Eruption number 4 had started. And I had to take a deep breath before I did my last update. And after it, I didn't get much sleep or before I took off to Reykjavík yesterday. And from Reykjavík, I did a trip to the Reykjanes Peninsula and the fissure was not very impressive when I got there. And most of the activity was at the northeast part of it. And to film there turned out to be extremely difficult. It was very windy, so drones were almost unusable. And it literally disappeared into the snow for a while. So I got a bit worried that I wouldn't be able to bring any footage back. But it isn't quite like that. But some of the footage is low light footage that needs some more work. So I'm leaving that for home. But I am, however, staying for another day and I'm going to see how the weather will turn out in the afternoon. And as for the volcano news, we are looking at a different scenario once again. Although we are still at risk. Like last night, rescue workers were asked to evacuate Grindavík once again because it's still considered possible that the fissure will extend in both directions. And the land uplift that was 35 centimeters before the eruption, the land has only dropped by 7 centimeters. And a new eruption, like by the Blue Lagoon, is still considered to be a possibility. Gas pollution has not been a big problem at the Keflavík International Airport. It's business as usual there. No delays. However, this is not a tourist volcano. Not yet, at least. It's still forbidden to hike up there. And I could spend a lot of time talking about the reason or the magma that might still be present under Svartsengi by the Blue Lagoon. So it's terribly hard to film this and it's frustrating and I even tried to do a helicopter deal this morning waiting for a reply and after this short video I'm going again to the Reykjanes Peninsula to see what I can get. But looking at the webcams now, this is fading out very fast. And experts said from the beginning that this would only last for a few days. So our biggest concern now is a question, is there still magma inflow into this sill by the Blue Lagoon? And if so, it's very bad news for Grindavík, because the risk will still be there or a new eruption that might start just any day now. However, our scientists are looking into this and I'm not making this any longer now since I want to use this day well so I can do my next report from home with hopefully plenty of footage. And with that I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island Iceland.